YouTubers, we're now halfway through the second series of Channel 4's conspiracy thriller, Utopia. So we're going to do a quick recap of the series so far to get you up to speed in time for the next episode, which is airing tonight. It's safe to say that the second series of Utopia hasn't disappointed. In fact, it's everything we wanted it to be and more. The season kicked off with an entire episode set in the 70s, exploring the origins of Janus and focusing on a young Philip Carvel and Milner, two young romantic scientists who are close partners. We saw how and why Janus was created in a heroic attempt to purge the population and ensure the survival of a much smaller human species in a time when non-renewable energy was running out. It was created by Carvel, who's the father of Jessica Hyde and Arby. We find out that Arby was experimented on as a baby, which has clearly resulted in his inability to empathise with his victims, as we saw so much in Series 1. We also saw that Carvel tampered with the virus once he'd finished it, although we don't know how. All we know is that it now can't be used for some reason, but that Carvel couldn't bring himself to destroy all his hard work, hence injecting the virus into Jessica to keep it safe permanently. Episode 2 brought us back to the present day, with Jessica being held prisoner by Milner at the Network HQ. Milner, with the help of the Rochane Foundation, has made Janus into a vaccine, and plans are underway to distribute it to the whole world on V-Day, which is a charity campaign allowing the developing world to have access to the vaccination on the same day as the Western world. The vaccination will protect the whole world against Russian flu, which has been built up to be a universal killer, similar to the Spanish influenza in the early 1900s. The only reason the network can't release the vaccine straight away is because they don't know what the adjustment is that Carvel made before disappearing back in the 70s. Carvel is thought to be dead, but episode 2 saw Becky and Donaldson come across a confused old man called Anton, who was later revealed in episode 3 to be Philip Carvel. He only speaks gibberish, except during one moment of clarity whilst watching a news report where he suddenly turns to Grant, that he's the young boy who's also on the run, and says, "Janus will kill everyone." Meanwhile, Ian and Becky have rekindled their romance, although they still believe that Milner's on their side. It's only after a phone call between Milner and Ian, in which she makes kind of a mistake and reveals that she knows more than she should, that Ian begins to suspect her. Back at the Network HQ, Jessica's refused to talk about the alteration of Janus, and they've resorted to performing surgery on her brain to extract the information instead. However, in classic Jessica style, she's managed to break free, killing the doctors and escaping, and she's now on the run. And Milner, believing that she'll never be able to capture Jessica again, has given the go-ahead on the Janus vaccination, despite not knowing what the effects are going to be. Episode 3 left us just at the point where Jeff, who's the head of the Department of Health and also an insider at the network, is just about to announce the vaccination to the whole nation, commencing V-Day. We came close to finding out what might have happened to the Janus virus when an innocent doctor who was involved with the project gets hold of a sample and tests it in her home lab with apparently shocking results. But before she can reveal any information, Dugdale has her killed, since he's still being forced to back the cause. In the second half of the series, we're expecting Carvel or Jessica to provide some last-minute knowledge about the effects of the vaccination, but we're not sure whether or not it's going to be too late. Also, we're expecting Dugdale to return to the good side and hopefully put a stop to the distribution somehow. We're also pretty excited to see how Milner reacts when she sees Carvel again, given their history in the 70s. And most of all, we're eager to see how the threat of Janus develops. Will it simply sterilise the whole world, or did Carvel's alteration create an even more sinister threat? We're just loving Utopia at the 86th floor. It's the first series in ages that's made me feel genuinely paranoid in real life. It totally strikes a chord with the current worry about population growth and of depleting supplies of non-renewable energy. Also, the cinematography, especially the saturated colouring and the modernist sort of angular compositions of the shots, are so beautiful and unlike anything else on TV at the moment. It's definitely one to watch, and we can't wait to see how it develops in the second half of the series. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe for more reviews and news about our favourite fantasy, sci-fi and horror shows. And please feel free to comment below if there's anything on our screens at the moment that you think we should be covering. Bye for now!